Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta, and welcome to Slay the Spire. We are back on the live client here, celebrating the release of the newest character, of course. The Defect, for those of you who did not know, is now live on Slay the Spire. So for those of you who are in the early access, you can now access the Defect without having to go to the PTR, which is awesome. We're just going to be doing a run here today. I don't know if we're going to win. That'd be cool if we do, but I'm not going to be surprised if we didn't. And here we go. Upgrade a card, obtain 100 gold, choose a rare card, or get a random boss relic. So I'm just going to do this sort of like a reintroduction to the Defect in case those of you who are new to the channel. Yeah, we'll just go for an upgrade. So basically the Defect is the third class in Slay the Spire, and the gimmick around this character is that it has an orb system. Think of it sort of like a passive and an active class. So what I mean by that is that the Defect starts off with these three slots that you can call orb slots, and you can evoke the orbs that are in there, or you can channel them to summon a new orb, taking the place of the leftmost orb, I guess, of the slot that you want to call it that. And if you evoke them, it basically triggers their active ability. Now, every orb has a passive ability as well. There is the lightning orb, which has the passive that deals 3 damage to a random enemy. That's automatically. As long as you have a lightning orb on your orb slot that has been channeled, it will do that passive effect. There's a frost orb, which will give you passive armor, the dark orb, which increases intensity and damage when you finally evoke it, and then the plasma orb, which will give you an extra energy for that round, which is very cool. So right now I'm going to use dual cast, and you see there it goes from 3 to 8, so 3 is the passive ability, and if I evoke it, it's now going to 8, and this is going to evoke it twice, so it's going to do 16 damage total, which is pretty darn awesome. I know that a lot of this is going to be redundant for some of you who've been following my progress with the Defect over the last couple of months now, and it's, I think it's important to let people know, just in case they've never seen my channel before, if they don't know anything about those runs, it's cool to reintroduce them to a character that I'm very familiar with at this point. We have Reprogram, Go for the Eyes, and Steam Barrier. I'm a big fan of Go for the Eyes. Reprogram is also not that bad either, because it sort of lets you dictate exactly what cards you're going to get, what cards you're not going to. This time around, I am going to go for Reprogram, but Go for the Eyes is very nice, especially since it does give you the ability to put weak on something. And that sort of hard damage mitigation is very nice. We want to keep Zap for the next turn. I don't really care too much about the other ones. We're basically guaranteed to draw dual cast along with it. There we go. So we're going to channel Zap. That's going to put a second lightning orb here in the free open slot. Might as well use Reprogram because it's inconsequential to do so right now. We'll throw away one of each. That's fine. And then we can also evoke now with dual cast, do 16 damage. We can strike him for actually a little bit of extra damage. Take 2 damage, not that big of a deal. But I'm a big fan of the Defect. He's probably my favorite character in the game. Self-Repair, Hello World, or Reprogram. I used to like Hello World. I'm not so high on it now unless you're going for some sort of a thick deck play. Since we don't really have an identity for this deck yet, I'm not really going to go for that route. I do like Self-Repair, however, because it does give you a little bit of added bonus at the end there to give you a little bit of extra HP back, which is very nice. Defragment is a fantastic card, so is All for One. Actually, most of these are pretty good. As you see here, they got a new graphic for double energy as well. The bandage is also fantastic as well, but this time around, I am going to go for Defragment. So, really quickly, what Focus is, Focus will increase the amount of damage done by the orbs when you evoke them, channel them, and passively. So, instead of our lightning, right now the base value is 3 for the passive damage. If we channel 1 focus, that's going to be 4. And if we increase the focus by 1 and then we evoke it, it's going to be 8. Same thing goes for frost orbs, dark orbs, etc., etc. So focus, increasing abilities and powers is very, very nice. Goodbye Sweeping Beam as well, as that would give us a little bit of card draw. For 22 gold, I don't think it's that big of a deal. Now, generally speaking, for the Defect, I tend to like a little bit of a thicker deck, only because there's a lot of options that you need to have for the Defect to work very well. I'm not actually going to attack here, because something that you may not know about the Louses is that their passive is not triggered by our passive. So if I just want to just defend till the cows come home, and just let the passive orbs do the lightning orbs do that, that's fine without ever having to worry about going through their armor. Might as well use a self-repair here, and then we'll just go ahead and defend up. This is a very common tactic for the defect as well, to hide behind a lot of block and just simply let your orbs do all the work for you. That should be it for both of them. There we go. And self-repair gets us back to full HP. Awesome. So we have compile driver, reinforced body, and boot sequence. Now we have a... This is a little bit of a different scenario here, because there's a compile driver. This... Basically, compile driver is a brand new card. I don't know when this card was added in the test phase, but this was not a card that existed the last time I played the defect on the test realm. So this is a very good card if you do have a lot of diversity in your orbs. Deal 7 damage, which is already great, and you get to draw a guaranteed card. So you basically get to deal 7 damage, and you're guaranteed to get at least one card draw, as long as you have something that is channeled. Even if you don't have anything channeled, though, it's still 7 damage. That's better than a regular strike. Reinforced body is not bad either. By the way, the new graphics are awesome. Same for boot sequence. I know people were sad about the removal of the boot sequence art, but I think that all these are all just fantastic. Boot sequence is very good as well as reinforced body, but I do like the fact that compile driver can sort of get out of control, especially later on if we start getting some plasma orbs, we get a lot of extra energy. Compile driver is going to be very, very good. All right, we just keep on rocking and rolling here. Defragment, let's go ahead and use reprogram. There's compile driver. We're probably actually going to use it. I'm going to get rid of this strike. We need to hold on to the defend and dual cast though. Self-repair, because we know we're going to take some damage here, and we want to get some damage out. Let's just do it on you. I'm not worried too much about 12 damage. Again, we're going to recover 7 of that back. It's not necessarily the best way to play, but I like having the... I sort of like having the... Just the backup. Alright, well, I guess we're just going to kill you then. No. Excuse me. You're supposed to die, sir. Or not, that's fine too. Alright. Alright, we were not supposed to take more damage this turn. So that did not work out as well as I would have liked. Go ahead and channel that. We'll go ahead and immediately evoke it here. So we're going to end up overall taking 12 damage. Assuming we don't take any more damage here, which is possible. Get rid of both those strikes. We want to get our channels back here. So you see there, we did not actually draw a card with the compile driver, because we didn't have any orbs that were evoked or channeled, I should say, which is okay. There we go. So we end up losing 12 HP. Not that big of a deal. Hologram, go for the eyes again, or chill. Chill is nice because it does give you the frost orb. However, it's sort of situational. It's very good in the later stages, in the second, and especially the third tower, when you have a lot of adds to go up against, and it's very good for cycling your orbs as well. So, while it's not necessarily something we're going to need right now in the first tower, it might be useful later on. And it's a free cost anyway, so it's really not a bad card. Normally, I would suggest going for an upgrade for Zap, but I actually prefer to upgrade Defragment. If you are lucky enough to get it early, changing that 1 to 2 focus is very, very helpful, especially if you start working along the lines with a bunch of frost orbs. Queue up self-repair, and we're just going to go to town here. It would have been nice if we had gotten that bandage as well, because that's a lot of extra healing that we could get. So this is going to be pretty bad here. Chill is fantastic. So I'm going to talk about cycling real fast here, for those of you, again, who are not familiar with this. Basically, if you have more orbs that you're able to channel, then you do free orb slots, what's going to happen is that these orbs will start rotating in from left to right, going in clockwise, to take the spots of the orb slots, regardless whether or not you have a free orb slot for 2, for 3, for 10,000, it doesn't matter. These are going to get channeled one way or the other. Now, what happens when one orb gets cycled out? So this one's going to get pushed out because we're going to channel 2 frost orbs here. Basically, the rightmost orb that gets pushed out will automatically be evoked. So once I play this, we are guaranteed to do at least 8 damage to one of these 2 targets, which is very good. And then this one's going to get pushed down to the right one. Actually, that one might get evoked as well. 1, 2, yeah. No, it won't. It won't. This one will stay to the right, and then we'll have 2 frost orbs here. So you see like this. Just watch the rightmost lightning orb. It's going to get cycled out. Does 8 damage to the slime, and then we get 2 frost orbs. Now, frost orbs will give us passive block just for us not doing anything. And then, of course, if we evoke it, we gain 5 block, which is very good later on. So for those of you who are looking to be a little bit more beefy, you can queue up a bunch of frost orbs, and it's very nice to have. Defragment does obviously affect the evoke power as well as the passive power of frost orbs in a nice way, so that's very good. Get rid of that, and I wish we could cycle out, and then we could double up our double up our frost orbs here. There we go. So we end up losing a little bit here, but not that bad. We still recover a little bit there with self-repair. Streamline, Hello World, and Lock On. Lock On is pretty nice because it deals 9 damage, which is something that I always overlooked. And even if you don't have any lightning or dark orbs, which usually they generally do their damage randomly, except for dark orbs. They're a little bit easier to control. But Lock On will do a guaranteed 9 damage, which is also very nice. For one cost, it's like a super strike almost. Let's go ahead and we're going to upgrade Zap this time. Again, it's very nice to have free channels. Anytime you can get a free channel on any orb, it's very good. Blood Vial doesn't really help us that much. And let's go ahead and what do we want to? We want to upgrade, let's see, Chill. Chill's not too bad to have innately, but I think that, honestly, going for self-repair, since we're using it so often, is very good. You can also upgrade Reprogram as well. Let's go ahead and fight a boss. Let's see how well the defect does against a boss. Look at that, we already top deck self-repair. I'm going to go ahead and use this, get Capacitor too. So now we have the ability to increase the amount of orb slots. Now I know what you're thinking. You're thinking that's awesome. More orb slots equals just incredible, right? Not necessarily. Not necessarily. And the reason why you say that is because basically, I don't want to wake up the Lagavulin yet. I want to get a Frost Orb out. A lot of the strength of the defect has to deal with it deals with his ability to cycle through his orbs. So if you have a lot of orb slots, you're not you're not necessarily going to want to not be able to get through all your orbs. And what I mean by cycle is by cycling them through the amount of orbs that you have. And again, because the evoke power is so good on a lot of orbs, especially the frost orbs, you're going to want to have a lot of turnover, and especially if you're even doubly, especially if you're upgrading these costs, these skills here down to 0, that allows you to have free cycle, which is very, very good. I'm gonna lock on. We might as well use reprogram. There's our free zap. Definitely want to hold on to defend, however. And now we could use multicast. I don't think there's really any reason to use multicast right now. In fact, I would go even a step further and say there's no reason to dual cast yet. And the reason why I don't want to dual cast yet is because we're going to need this extra damage, given the fact that our physical damage is about to be reduced by a whole lot. So Sweeping Beam is going to allow us to draw a card. We'll use Lock On for 11 damage. We'll go ahead, and now we will evoke. And hopefully, we should have him dead this turn. Multicast will do it. That's going to be 30 damage. There we go. Get Anchor, awesome. Get another self-repair, boot sequence, lock on. I mean, I'm willing to go double self-repair. That's pretty nice. Heal 25, or we can receive a relic. There's no more stores that we can go to. I'm just going to heal. This allows us the option to upgrade even further in our next... You know, hey, look at that. We got a shop anyway. Melter is very good because it allows us to destroy all the block and then deal damage, but I can't pass up Dark Orbs. Dark Orbs are so good. So let me talk about Dark Orbs really fast. As we go into the next unknown event. Well, here's the hoping that we find Frost Orb, because even though it's slimes, this group is actually kind of dangerous. We're not going to find it. Let's go for that, and I will go for Defragment first. I'm hoping that we're going to be able to get a cycle through our deck here. We should. So, let me talk about Dark Orbs really fast before I lose track here. So basically what Dark Orbs are, Dark Orbs will allow you to channel a very, very powerful orb. And what it does is, it's not going to do anything passively except increase in strength. However, when you evoke it, it's going to deal that amount of damage to the target with the lowest HP. So I'll go ahead and channel it real quickly here. So as you see here, at the end of the turn, increase this orb's damage by 8. So it's doing 8 right now. If you evoke it, it deals 6 damage right now. If we evoke it, it's going to go up to 14. And it will deal its damage to the enemy with the lowest HP, period. Now, if there's a tie, I believe it's done randomly. So that's very good. I need to go ahead and cycle out all of this. So we could probably actually wipe all three of these out right now by using Chill and then Sweeping Beam if for some reason we don't kill them all. There we go. Look at that. We get 10 HP back. Offer 1, Chaos, and Sweeping Beam. Offer 1's really, really good. Chaos is also really good. I'm going to go for All for One. It's hard to pass up a rare card like that. And let's go ahead. We can upgrade either to Darkness, which we can channel 2 orbs, which is very good. Or we can deal more damage with All for One. Honestly, I think that upgrading the Darkness one, it's just having 2 Dark Orbs at once is just really powerful. And hopefully I'll get to show that to you versus the Hexaghost here. I'm going to start speeding up a little bit because 15 minutes on the first floor. I mean, I've been doing a lot of explanation, but usually doesn't take me this long. All right, so here we go. So I need to obviously evoke or channel the chill right now because we're going to need the extra block, especially since we didn't freaking draw any. No defends. Wow. We drew 1 defend. I'm going to go ahead and channel the darkness now, too. That way we still get the benefits of having the lightning orbs being there, but obviously we're going to take a ton of damage. Let me go for All for One. Have we used any zero costs? Only dual... Oh, yeah, dual cast and zap. Yeah, that'll work. So dual cast is going to give us 10 armor because we're going to double evoke our frost orb. And then we can replace our back orb slot with a zap for lightning. Now you see here, you see how fast the damage of these dark orbs ramp up. Now just picture that with defragment and with dual cast. Yeah. It's a lot of damage. A whole lot of damage. We don't need Sweeping Beam. I will hold on to Darkness because we're about to evoke one of our Dark Orbs here. We're going to take a lot of damage. We basically need to end this. We need to end this fight soon. Use Compile Driver. All for One. Would not get it. It'd get us Zap, but it would not get us Dual Cast. I really want to use Dual Cast here. Or do I want to evoke? Let's evoke. Yeah. We'll have to dual cast lightning. I'm not sure if that was the right play or not. Let's lock on. And since it's not attacking now, I'm actually going to dual cast now. And that's going to allow our dark orbs to hopefully get charged up. But we've got to end this fight pretty soon. And look at that, we just top decked All for One, which is great. Because it's going to allow us to dual cast right now if I want to. Pull the defend out here, and we'll use All for One. So this is going to be 44 damage. Here to burn here. It was a nice job. We pulled a reprogram back from All for One. Again, All for One's a fantastic, fantastic card. There we go. So all we need to do now is just draw dual cast, and this fight's over. We did not get it. Let's see if we can get it here. Reprogram. It's coming up next, but I think that this one's already done anyway because we've got a darkness orb that's going to evoke one, and then the lightning orb. Not quite enough, but this one will definitely be enough. There we go. A little bit sketchy there. So Thunderstrike, Buffer, and Machine Learning. So I don't like Buffer because it just costs too much. It is nice that it's nice to have, but it only activates once, and that's it. And it completely negates all the damage you would have taken, but I don't really, like I said, I don't like it. Machine Learning is very good. It allows you to draw an additional card for each turn. And then you also have Thunderstrike, which is fantastic because if you use this with lock-on, you can do an incredible amount of damage. You're basically doing single target damage. So Thunderstrike, definitely going to be using Thunderstrike here. Deal 7 damage to a random enemy for each lightning channel this combat. And as you can see, we don't have a lot of problems channeling a whole lot of lightning orbs very quickly. So that's going to be very powerful. It's a good finishing card, and it doesn't exhaust, which means that you can use it more than once per combat. So far, this run's not the greatest, not the worst, but it's definitely not the strongest defect run that I've seen so far. We definitely want to hit up this shop here. We're back to full HP here, which is very nice. Well, we don't have to defend because we have the anchor, so let's go ahead and get all these bad boys lined up. Now, there is a very common tactic that I've seen other players use, which is quite simply, you just wait for your Dark Orbs, like one full rotation, just wait for the Dark Orbs to charge up, and then you just dual cast and just basically, well, wreck house. We'll go lock on just to deal the damage. We use the chill as we get ready for dual cast, which will be coming up very soon. Let's get rid of all these so we get self-repair. We can basically undo all the damage, and there's dual cast, and that is one dead parasite. Let's see. Self-repair, dual cast, and pile driver. Compile driver. Doom and Gloom, Rebound, and Chaos. I still don't like Doom and Gloom. It is nice to have all that AoE, but it's just too... It costs too much for what it does. It only channels one Dark as well, which is why I don't like it. Now, Rebound is very good. However, I do like the upgraded Chaos because this gives you a random type of orb, and you get two of them when it's upgraded. So I will take Chaos, which is a very, very fun card, especially if you're looking for some cycle. Unfortunately, we cannot get Ice Cream, which makes me sad. I do like Recursion. Recursion allows you to evoke the next orb and channel the orb that was just evoked. So basically, if we have a Lightning Orb all the way at the very right and then two Frost Orbs behind it, assuming we have three orb slots, if we play Recursion, it's going to evoke the Lightning Orb, shift the two Frost Orbs forward, and then put another Lightning Orb behind the two Frost Orbs. So it's very, very good for cycle. Again, cycling as the defect is very, very key. Barrage is also kind of okay. I'm not a huge fan of Barrage, but if you have like a 10 orb slot deck, it is kind of good. I actually am going to remove a little bit because we have a little bit too much fluff in our deck here. Get rid of Strike. I don't really want a Swift Potion. I think we can hold off and everything else. All right, so here we go. This is what Melter was made for, but unfortunately we don't have Melter, so... Reprogram, and let's get rid of the stuff that we know we're probably not going to want. We actually want all four of those, so it's not bad at all. And another thing I like about Reprogram is that it really just gives you the freedom of knowing that you can, knowing what cards you can expect on the next turn, and essentially you make your own deck in a way. We can use Dual Cast here. I'll use one of these, Darkness or Chaos. Let's see what we get for Chaos. Hey, look at that. There's the Plasma Orb. That's the final orb slot that you've not seen yet. So, passively, we gain an extra energy. If we evoke it, we gain two energy, which is very good. But it's unaffected by focus, just so you all know. Let's go ahead and use All for One. It's going to bring back Reprogram, Zap, and Dual Cast, which I'm going to use right now for armor. Reprogram. Let's make sure that we get... Yeah, Recursion is good. Compile Driver. Probably won't need Compile Driver, and we definitely don't need Lock-On, but, I mean, it's a really good hand anyway. Not going to complain about that. And even though we're taking a lot of damage here, who really cares? I mean, we've got a lot of ways to heal ourselves. Bam, look at that. Double self-repair is nice. Triple self-repair. Now we're just getting silly. Tempest is nice for the, you can channel X amount of lightning, where X equals the amount of energy you have. Streamline is also a very good card. I'm just going to get crazy with it. Let's just go for another self-repair. Why not? Why not? Call us the Immortal Defect. You can't stop us. You can only hope to contain us. Compile Driver doesn't really help us unless we draw some of our free cards, which we did not. I could use a Gambler's Brew, but we're about to... we heal so much after every combat. Who really cares? Again, another fantastic hand. I'm looking forward to next round, that's for sure. All right, let's go self-repair. Get the chill out of the way so we get a little bit of armor. And we can recursion cycle our lightning orb and then use chaos, and let's see what we get. We got one lightning, one frost. Not too bad. Look how much armor we've gained here thanks to our focus as well, our increased focus. Use another self-repair because, I mean, why not? Lock on. We're going to lock on to the knight. So for the next round, for this round, the one that just happened, and then this round here, our damage is not going to be random. It's going to be completely focused on the Centurion, which is very good because we need to get him out of here. In fact, we're going to refocus. And one, two. It's not going to be enough to kill him. Almost, though. Now's a good time for Thunderstrike. This would deal a guaranteed 28 damage to the Centurion. Is there a way? Is there a better way we could do that? I don't think so. I'm just going to Thunderstrike. Apparently, Thunderstrike is not affected by lock-on. That's good to know. I actually thought it was. Unless that's a change or if that's something that I knew but just didn't remember. That's a little bit sad face. So, yeah, I guess that's good to know. So, lock-on indeed does not affect the Thunderstrike. Could have swore it did. There we go. Look how much... let's not get silly. No, we do need another way to channel lightning, so we'll get ball lightning, but I really wanted to pull the trigger on that fourth self-repair. I'm not going to lie. All right, so we can increase the effect of Thunderstrike up to 10. Or 9, sorry, per lightning orb. We deal 11 damage, which is also very good. Compile driver, we can upgrade that to 10. That is the 10 I was thinking of. 9 damage, draw a card. Top 6 cards for reprogram. I've been using reprogram a lot, so let's go ahead and boost that one up a little bit. We've got a lot of upgrades coming our way, so this is no big deal. Fortunately, we ran into a fight in our unknown event, which is a little bit sad face, but what can you do? Absolutely, get all these self-repairs. It's beautiful. Not going to use Thunderstrike. So we're going to take a little bit of damage here, but again, we're healing for 27. Let's get that focused here. Actually, focus didn't go off because of the artifact buff. That's okay. Get a lightning orb, and we got another lightning orb. All right. I think we'll go for dual cast. And then compile driver just to... Actually, no, there's no reason to use compile driver here. So we still made 20 block, almost 20 block, without even playing any defend cards, which is great. That was before playing defragment as well. Definitely want to channel a darkness orb. And the spirit guardian is not long for this world. Wow, no dual cast, huh? Oh no, all for one makes sense. Everything else doesn't. Just not quite enough damage. I was hoping we could kill it before he did that to us, but oh well. Alright, we've got Tempest, Blizzard, Static Discharge. Tempest makes sense because it allows you to basically beef up Thunderstrike's abilities. Static Discharge is also not that bad. Blizzard is also not that bad if you have a lot of Frost Orb channeling abilities, which we do not. This time around, I think I am going to go for Tempest. And let's go ahead and upgrade. What do you want to upgrade? Recursion for free is very nice. Need to be a little bit careful because we do have an elite fight coming up, so I may rest on this next one. Yeah, we're going to need to rest because we also have two more fights coming up as well. Or I could go here. No, because I don't want to waste the... I mean, some people would say that wasting the bonfire is resting, but I disagree. Well, this is not exactly what I wanted to see. We're going to have to use our weakness potion. Everyone knows the OP plant. I'm not going to use dual cast here because we want to at least get a constant stream of offense on this thing. We can use recursion. All for one. Get our dual cast and recursion back. And we certainly need to play all of our self-repairs before even thinking about getting out of this fight. Self-repair. There's our other self-repair, but unfortunately, I think this is going to be dead before then. Is there any way to keep it from dying? I guess not. I mean, I'm being greedy now, but... Alright, I got another Darkness, Doom and Gloom Rebound. I like Darkness. All right, we got. Look at this. What a great start here. We got chill, recursion, all for one, and recursion. That's a really good starting hand. All right, so Happy Flower did proc, which means we have extra energy this time around. And let's use reprogram and get rid of all the stuff we don't want. Chaos is great. Let's see what we get. Got a plasma energy, or we got plasma orb. I'm actually not going to use darkness because we may need the energy. Since neither of them are attacking right now, we may need the plasma orb. We get three cards. We get Tempest, Lock-On, and Ball Lightning. I can Tempest now, and that would give us two extra energy to play with. Like that. Alright, then we use Lock-On, Ball Lightning. So you see how powerful plasma orbs are. They're very nice to have. And I know we haven't been using Thunderstrike, but to be honest, we haven't had to, which is very nice. I just did that for the physical damage. We know that the Mystic is not going to be around much longer. Let's see, reprogram. What am I looking for here? Do we have anything else that I care about to draw? I don't think so. Full HP. Fine with me. Cool Headed is nice because it gives you card draw and you channel a Frost Orb. Give us a little bit more flexibility, and we're certainly going to need it for this freaking piece. You know what I mean. We're not going to want Compile Drive. We're going to need Block. And by that I mean we're going to just cycle everything out and hope that we get a bunch of Frost Orbs. All right, so let's get Chaos. We did get Plasma, which is nice. The problem is that it's wasted on this turn. I'm going to channel Zap. I'm not going to channel Darkness, as dumb as that may seem. Because we're going to need the block, or we're going to need the energy this turn. Now I'm a little bit sad that we didn't keep the, we did not keep the Compile Driver. That was stupid. We're motivated to get out of this fight as fast as possible. The Book of Stabbing is an extremely dangerous fight. It wouldn't die if we use Tempest here. I will use Cool Headed though. Okay, so all we need. All we need is dual cast. That's not dual cast. Would Tempest do it? 1, 2, 3. It would cycle out one. That'd be 30. Tempest would not kill him. We would need to draw into exactly dual cast here. We did not. We just need to hit him for two. Oh, we got a light. Oh, that's right. We're going to get the passive from the lightning orbs. That's right. Never mind. I overthought that way too much. Melter stack and conserve battery stacks already upgraded. This allows you to get the number of you get block equal to the number of cards that you're in your discard pile plus 3, which is very good. I like Melter, don't get me wrong. Upgrade a card. Awesome. Let's, I want to upgrade here. Tempest or All for One? Also get two card draw. I think I'm going to actually upgrade Tempest. Because that allows us to channel, even if we don't have enough like energy to make a cycle, we still have a chance to cycle out something, guaranteed. All right, this is not the best hand that I've ever seen. There we go. Defragment's what I was looking for. I'm gonna drink Gambler's Brew. We did get dual cast. So it's gonna be almost enough to kill that left minion. Almost. Really hoping it wasn't gonna take our all for one. That's all right. We can all for one here. Then we can get recursion, which is going to do not the damage that I want. Let's go zap. Recursion. There we go. And we got Thunderstrike back. Okay. So now our job gets a little bit more stressful because now we have to worry about blocking against the Mega Beam. And since we don't have a way of weakening him, it's going to be a little bit iffy. This is where it's this type of fight where Thunderstrike really comes in and saves your saves your butt, because we've already doing 56 damage to this. I'm going to use Chaos first before Thunderstrike, because it's possible that we might channel even more Lightning Orbs out of this. We got Plasma and another Lightning Orb, okay? Let's go for... We need to get Plasma around again to use Thunderstrike now, which is what I want. So this should give us 3. Okay. Then we're going to Thunderstrike for 63. Then we're going to... We need all the defense we can get. All for one's not going to do it, unfortunately. Yeah, we need all the defense we can get next turn. Hopefully we get dual cast as well. Alright, cool headed. This is going to give us at least 7 block right now. We got stack. Now stack might actually be huge here. That's going to give us an extra 13 block, and then we have 34 after the frost orb. So we're only going to take 17 damage. That's fantastic considering that we didn't have much. Really good. Really, really good. So now the bronze automaton is stunned. And I am going to channel ball lightning and then darkness. And now we're just drawing until we get Thunderstrike, and this one's over. Compile Driver won't help us because if we draw Thunderstrike, we won't be able to play it. And as luck would have it, he has the exact amount to ruin our Lizard Tail. We need to draw literally any block. Literally any block. We drew literally no block. Wow. That is actually quite Sinvicta luckish. Well, there you go on that, everyone. If you ever wanted to see Sinvicta luck in the flesh, look no further than this right here. We're not going to lose our life, but man. Oh, that's freaking hilarious game. That's good old fashioned Sinvicta luck right there. And he's dead from the lightning orb. Well, we didn't die, and we saved our life, so I guess there's no real complaining. Echo Form, first card you play each turn is played twice, which is very good. Multicast is nice, as well as all for one, of course. We'll go Echo Form. And this is just a terrible, awful boss trinket again. Woo! All right, I guess we're taking White Beast Statue. I do like the new potions. Did they change Echo Form to be non-ethereal now? No, I'm still ethereal. All right. It's unfortunate. We are going up against the Awakened one, which directly counters any power-based decks like ours. But I guess we don't have to use the self repair because I mean this is just the end of the fight, or the end of the run, I should say. 1, 2, 3 upgrades, but 2 elites to get to it. 1, 2, 3 upgrades with 0 elites. That sounds a lot nicer. Is there a store on the way? Yes, there is at the very end. Okay. Alright. We definitely want all for one. Because, I mean, look how many zero-cost cards we've got coming up. So all for one's going to be huge here. We'll keep ball lightning. No, we don't want ball lightning. Alright, so we're going to go with a little bit of dual cast or recursion. Let's go for recursion first. Dual cast. We're going to use all for one. Then we're going to go dual cast. Yeah, dual cast. And then recursion. Reprogram. We're not going to use Thunderstrike right now. Stack is also a pretty good card to have, however. Hold on to that one. And we can go self-repair or compile driver. Compile driver, we would have to have this... We would have to have this lightning orb hit there. But I think it's a little bit of a long shot. I'd rather just... Let's get our... Oh, and of course it hit there. I'd rather get the guaranteed heal after this fight. Defragment. Definitely want to chill it up. So we have a full stack of... full stack of frost orbs. And then stack gives us another huge amount of block, which is so good. That's the reason why you want thick decks. I think we go chaos, get some block. All right, nice. We got plasma. That's good. And we can go for Tempest next, which would give us more energy. Go zap, just because it's a free cycle. Darkness and then cool headed. I'd rather get block first. Get lock on. We have to play Echo Form if we want any benefit out of it. Do we really want Echo Form? I'm gonna say no. So Echo Form is ethereal, meaning that it will disappear forever if you don't use it right away. A recursion will take out this one. I'm gonna use Chaos so it takes out. Well, we can end the fight here. Watch this. There we go. Gain 27 HP back. Claw, Skim. Wow, they changed Skim, huh? Skim used to do something different. Claw is great because it's a free attack, and we have all for one. We can add three colorless cards. I mean, we've got plenty of HP, so I say go for it. Not exactly what I wanted. Thinking ahead, Mind Blast is fantastic for a thick deck. Deep Breath is also really good. Alright, so we gotta be a little bit careful about our HP here. I am gonna go Echo Form this time, because that, if you think about it, that will allow us to play Self-Repair twice, which is just, you can't see me doing it, but I'm giving you the okay symbol with my fingers. It's just, good stuff. Inexplicably, we didn't get self-repair here, even though I could have swore that we just used... Alright. Well, let's go for darkness then. Alright, and then we'll go for a little bit of a Zapparino. And a cool-headed. There's our self-repair that I needed, game. And of course we wouldn't get the self-repair that's upgraded, either. It's very funny, game. Very funny. Let's get 30 block with this. Defragment, self-repair. You wonder how Sinvicta gets so lucky. The answer is, I have no idea, dude. All I wanted was to play self-repair twice, game. Is that too much to ask? Equilibrium, beam cell, cool-headed, upgraded. Gain 13 block, retain your hand this turn, which is very nice for equilibrium. Beam cell, again, would speak to our zero cost. Alright, let's go beam cell. Thank you, Juzu. Sneka oil, hooray. Let's go ahead and take care of that for you right now. Wow, this is just as trolly as it gets, game. Wow. That is actually infuriating. That's ridiculous. It takes two of the cards that, like, our entire deck has been based around. It's a very funny, game. Alright. I can't lose Reprogram. Reprogram is just too dang valuable in this situation. We need to take out the Exploder. Exploder has been dealt with. Now we begin the long campaign against the two Spikers here. There we go. That worked out perfectly. Like, we can't lose All for One, and we certainly are not going to lose Reprogram. I'm just really salty that we lose our freaking other repair. Oh well. Let's see here. We're going to take some damage if I attack. I don't have to attack. It's only 5 damage. Well, 10 damage total. Let's just use Mind Blast. I don't want to really do anything else right now. Mind Blast, and we can take down one of the Spikers. There we go. And now all we need is just the other... We just need another dual cast, and this Dark Orb will do the rest for us. All for One. I appreciate you showing up on time, as always. However, you are not needed at the current moment. There we go. Upgraded beam cell again. Another Tempest. I mean, Tempest would, again, boost our ability to beef up Thunderstrike's power. Man. This is rough because I really want to upgrade Echo Form, but having Mind Blast be innate is very good. Again, keep in mind that we also have All for One, which allows us to recall Mind Blast immediately. Mind Blast before we use Compile Driver. Beam Cell is great. And Tempest I will play. Even if it's just one. Remember, we have another Tempest. Alright, thinking ahead, we'll put Recursion back to the top of the pile. Get our free Frost Orb. And we know that the Jawworm is going to power up this turn. So we're going to use Recursion. We're going to use Darkness first. Darkness. Recursion. Then All for One. Beam Cell. Recursion. Zap. Mind Blast. It's a good amount of damage. Self-repair, of course. We don't want Tempest. We do want Echo Form next turn because we know that he's not going to attack. So that's 30 damage here. I do not want to use Cool Headed at all. I think we take the 30 damage now. And we're only taking 16. It's not that big of a deal. We're undoing that next fight. So there we go. Dual cast, deep breath, might as well. Well, that's a little unfortunate, but Mind Blast is a great play here, and actually might actually just be dead. Thanks to Echo Form. Yeah, deep breath. And then Mind Blast again. Compile Driver. Yeah, he's dead. Wow, that was really good. Smoke Bomb is very good in case we run into something I really don't want to fight. Essence of Steel is great. Force Field, go for the eyes. It will finally help us weaken stuff. Force Field's really good, especially if we can get it down to zero. And we get Art of War. Topping the list of more relics that nobody really wanted. Actually, we're not going to get a store here. Do I want to try to get a store? It's possible we could see one up here. We do have Juzu beads, though. We would have to fight for the store. I don't know if we want to. I'm going to be real lazy here and just nope on out of this fight. No thanks. I'm going to be risky and say that hopefully we, out of these three, thanks to Juzu, I'm hoping that we get one store. We get Madness. And a store. All right. I don't feel so stupid. We get another Claw. Dramatic Entrance doesn't really help us that much. Auto Shields is very good. Bronze Talons, or we could remove a card. I think a Claw would be nice. Buffer is not going to help us against Awakened One. Pretty underwhelming store, I've got to say, Uncle Deckard. Now, it's possible we could find another store here. This could be a store. Let's screw it. Let's just try it. Alright, we are going to need to upgrade Echo Form. I do not want to have the risk of it going away against the Awakened One. That's... Hooray. Alright. We have two lives. We're going to recover... So we'll be at 68. As silly as that may seem, I want to be at full strength. I don't want to have any excuses going up against this jerk. We have Lock On. I do want to have... If we can get a free Thunderstrike, that's huge. Like, huge. Chaos... And this will get us free Thunderstrike. That's awesome. Wow, we get a free Thunderstrike for this entire fight. That is so massive. Thinking ahead here. We're not going to play either one of these, so I'm going to put our free Thunderstrike back on the top of this of the pile here. Good start for us. Let's Lock On. Compile Driver. Tempest is so big. Do not want Strike. Do not... Do we want Darkness? We need to get Echo Form out. Yeah. Alright, so we're going to channel Tempest here. This is going to give us a ton of energy, by the way. I really wish that we had one more way to cycle so we could actually get more out of Tempest, but it is what it is. There we go, we're gonna Thunderstrike here. Echo Form for sure. It's gonna give the Awakened one a little bit more damage, which is okay. Need to use stack here. So Echo Form, now that that's active, that gives us a lot more options. And we can play Defragment twice, which would help us with focus. But you gotta remember that's also powering up the Awakened one here. I think that we gotta do it though. Go big or go home, that's what I say. Darkness is great. Alright, so we have our darkness orbs ticking away now. Probably should have thought about that. I completely forgot that we had Echo Form up. Okay. Probably not going to need Compile Driver or Lock On right now. I will keep Chaos. And then we're not going to need Self-Repair or the card draw there. I will keep one Defend. We're not through our life yet, but it's real close. 9 damage. And we'll channel Chaos here. Okay, we did get a Frost Orb, which is what I was hoping for. We're going to lose our life. So it's getting a little bit iffy right now. We just need to push him over. Cycle that out. Darkness is a fantastic pickup here. Oh my goodness. Darkness was a great, great top deck there. That may have saved this run almost. Beam Cell. Get that out. Madness, I'd like for you to land on Ball Lightning if you can, please. Alright. Alright. Only 3 damage here. I think we can put him over, though. Yeah, actually we can because we can use Deep Breath. I'm not going to actually do that, though. What's left in our... Yeah, we want to have Thunderstrike ready to go next turn. So, let's just push him over. I'm going to use Recursion. I'm not going to use Dual Cast. But you know what? I have to use Dual Cast. Okay, that's fine. Hit him. Yeah, and I don't want to use Deep Breath. Okay. Alright, we're doing 49 damage. Zinvicta, stop using that! Use Force Field, you nerd! I'm mad at my... I keep forgetting that we have Echo Form. It's my own dang fault. And trust me, I'm upset. I'm more mad at myself than you are, I promise. Alright, you have Echo Form. You have Echo Form. We're making boneheaded plays right now. This does not help us here, game. If only we had Dual Cast. I'm gonna go Ball Lightning so we evoke the Frost Orb. Just to get some block. Might as well use Beam Cell. Sweeping the Pile Driver. We're down to 9 HP. Where did the Void... Oh, it came from him. Alright. Well, unfortunately, we are not going to make it. 100% my bad. 100% my bad. I fully admit that there are so many misplays because I forgot about Echo Form. Good run nonetheless, though. 1 hour long. I wasn't planning on it having an hour long run, but I also don't have all the cards unlocked. That should get us a nice chunk of nothing, I guess. All right. So thanks for watching, everyone. Make sure you go try out the Defect. It's a fantastic character. Probably my favorite character in Slay the Spire. Let me know what your favorite card is for the Defect down below in the comment section. Of course, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.